And one way they're doing it is because after they move throughout the full effect of 30 meters or so, and then they decay. So in the mass range of scalars that is picked out from the Higgs mass, you have all three possibilities depending on the Luna mass and the scalar mass. For light scalar masses, the decay of the Luna are from. For intermediate scalar masses, they are displaced. And eventually, you can get collider stable Lunas on the high range of the scalar mass. So that is perhaps the most important signature. There have been searches within the popular theory, even among experimentalists. So nowadays, it's the second thing we look for after natural supersymmetry. So they have already bound. This is one bound, I showed something like this similar before. So the limit on the Luna mass are the function of the mass of the lightest supersymmetric particle. Again, the Luna mass is constrained to be above the TV or above. So either from or slightly displaced Lunas. At the moment, we don't know the difference. So here it is. And again, as before, if the LHC mass is above 350 GeV, the Luna can be light. So this is an atlas. There is a CMS. There are CMS and atlas searches for both of these. Here is a CMS search for collider-stable gluons. These are gluons that produce and travel more than the detector length before they decay. So they create functional type signatures. So this is the limit that you're supposed to read off from here is that the gluon mass for collider-stable gluon is more than about the TV. This other line that you see, this is the corresponding limit for collider-stable stop. This has to be more than 600 GeV. And this is collider-stable spout. It has to be more than 450 GeV or so. The most optimistic case for Sweet is if the gluon is less than 3 TeV or so, then it should be produced and seen with characteristic decay. And also, gluons are also accessible at the OHC, especially in this gluon transfer remote that I presented where the gluon to scalar masses are fully related. A very popular topic since at least last October is what can the Higgs tell us about the dichotomy between natural mass and the multiverse? And the point continues to be the same, it has not yet been clarified experimentally, is that a natural Higgs is not a standard model Higgs. In other words, any solutions to the natural mass problem involve some new physics sampling the quadratic divergences to the Higgs mass. And the very same processes that do that when attached with gluons or with photons contribute to the production of the Higgs and also to the decay of the Higgs. So the production of the Higgs through gluons and the decay of the Higgs through photons is also mediated by the same new physics process. So if there is light new physics around 100 GeV, which solves the hierarchy problem, it is bound to influence the properties of the Higgs. And starting in December and continuing until July 4th of this year, including July 4th of this year, there has been some very preliminary hints of a possible deviation of the Higgs properties from those of the standard model Higgs. And that has to do with the production of the Higgs through the gamma-gamma channel, production of the Higgs when it deviates through the gamma-gamma channel, which seems to be within big error bars, within two sigma or so, higher than the standard model prospects. By factor of 1.5 or so. It's very preliminary, but it is something that experimentalists are focusing on and will try to clarify as much as possible until December and of course after the 2010, after the 14th event. So this is one of the hopes that we have for seeing evidence for the only standard model physics through the Higgs. So conclusions of what we have learned in the last couple of years from the LHC is first that natural supersymmetry, because of the Higgs mass, requires a new ingredient, perhaps a singlet, or a new G1 in the supersymmetric standard model, assuming that it is not a very tuned theory. The Luna mass constraints, that are the constraints that are coming the fastest, because the Luna is such an easy particle to produce, push natural supersymmetry to the corner and will continue to do so in the next few months of this year. LHC may exclude natural supersymmetry by 2012. Again, by natural supersymmetry, I mean things not being tuned more than 100%. Split supersymmetry Higgs points, the main development was a Higgs point to the theory that was called mini-split, where the scalar masses are not far above the non-TV scale.